So hello everyone, this is Shelly and for today's video I have picked up 5 famous products from my bucket of emptied products and I'll be sharing my final opinion on them. And I prefer reviewing product after they are fully used up and are empty instead of giving first impression, because I have had products in the past which I really liked in the beginning, but as I used them more and more I actually started hating them. First product which I have here is the Cosrx Low pH First Cleansing Milk Gel. Now, as the name says, this is more like your cleansing milk but with a thicker gel cream like consistency, and this is to be used on dry skin. Like, you take a little massage on your dry skin and wet your palm and again massage for a few seconds and rinse it off with the plain water. But make sure that you do follow up with the foaming cleanser after using this product. So as for my experience, when I started using this in the beginning, I found it okay, like nothing too bad, nothing too good, it was okay. But as I used it more and more, I actually started liking it a lot, mainly because with this in a routine, I saw that I had less whiteheads around my nose. Weirdly enough, I don't get blackheads, but I get whiteheads, and this was very effective in reducing that. And also, since I'm someone who doesn't wear makeup on daily basis, this is perfect to remove your sunscreen, your regular base makeup and regular lip product. This is very effective on that. And also, I really liked the subtle citrusy scent in it. And so if you are someone who doesn't like cleansing oil or balm or cleansing water, this is definitely for you. And since we are talking about the first step cleanser, the next product I have is also a first step cleanser, and it is the Neogen Real Flower Cleansing Water with Calendula. Now, this is a very interesting product. It had a real floating calendula petals, and calendula is really good to calm and soothe your skin. And this cleansing water is made for the sensitive skin kind, something which I have, the entire world knows. And so for my experience, I would say, like, when I had this in a routine, it was okay, it was fun to use, it did the good job of removing sunscreen and base makeup. The only two problems, the two major problems which I had with this one is that, first of all, it had a really strong artificial fragrance. I prefer my products to be fragrance free, if not at least with the subtle scent. I hate strong fragrance in my product. And the second one, if I used it around my eyes, oh my god, it stung so bad. So the next product which I have here is again a very famous one, and it is the Claire Supple Preparation Unscented Toner. Now, as the name says, this is the fragrance free version of their very famous original toner. And I personally like this over the original one, mainly because it doesn't contain any essential oil, it is 100% fragrance free, and I find it perfect for the summer and monsoon. Like, in comparison to the original toner, this is a little less hydrating and has a little watery consistency, like in comparison to the original one, but still I prefer this as it doesn't irritate my skin, and plus it is so easy to use on cotton puff, and also it is perfect for layering. And if you have sensitive or acne prone skin, I would recommend this over the original one. And the next product I have is the Tony Moly the Black Tea London Classic Serum. Now, this is their serum from their famous black tea line. They have the toner, the cream, the serum, and maybe little more product. So this has a very serum oil like consistency. And what I liked about this is that whenever I had this in my routine was simple. Like, I used a toner, this serum and moisturizer at night or sunscreen in the daytime, and I was good to go for my day or night. I didn't see any brightening or any added benefit, but I had this product, I enjoyed it, I have no complaint. But I will not be repurchasing this. The next product I have is a very famous product from the brand Misha, and it is the Super Aqua Cell Renew Snail Cream. And as the name says, it does contain a certain percentage of a snail mucin filtrate, and snail mucin filtrate is amazing to help prepare your skin and as well as to brighten up your skin tone. And I actually bought this during last monsoon, because at that time I needed something less sticky and more hydrating. So I bought this product, and but when I applied this on my skin, I actually got annoyed, mainly because it had really strong fragrance. So I passed this on to my mom, who has oily skin and she's not bothered by the fragrance in a product. So she used this product for me, and overall she did like it. Like, she did enjoy the moisture effect and the overall feel on skin, but apart from that she didn't notice any brightening or any wow effect. So that's it for today's video, and I actually do have lot of empty product. So if you have any particular product in your mind that you want me to review, make sure you comment down below so that I can include it in the next empty video. And I will see you next time with more amazing video, and until then, bye bye.